Capitol Hill has become a second home to Jerry Ensminger. The retired Marine drill sergeant says he's still fighting for the rights of Americans.
The Marine Corps has a motto, and their official motto is Semper Fidelis, which is Latin for always faithful.
But Ensminger and the Marine Corps are now pitted against each other.
Unfortunately, I found out that not only do they not live up to their motto, they won't take care of their own unless you force them to.
The battle is over water. Water that was contaminated at Camp Lejeune, North Carolina. The problem came from a dry cleaning chemical called tetrachloroethylene and a metal degreaser called trichloroethylene.
We wanted to visit Camp Lejeune, but our request was denied. The Marine Corps says the contamination has been widely publicized since 1984 when it was first discovered. But Ensminger and others couldn't disagree more.
They believe thousands of people could now be ill, and Ensminger wants the Marine Corps to admit there's a link. He's trying to force the Corps to notify those people who lived or worked at the base between 1968 and 1985. He says the Department of Veterans Affairs should be providing health benefits to people like Nick Geiger of Baltimore.
I just feel like I'm getting kicked in the teeth by the government that I served.
Geiger feels the Marine Corps held back information about the contamination when it occurred. The Marine Corps says that's not true. Geiger drove a hospital bus to the base for about a year in the 1970s. Now he has liver problems and suffers from headaches, blood clots, and tumors. He's been denied medical and financial benefits from the VA five times over the last 5 years.
I volunteered to join the Marine Corps at the age of 17. My parents signed paperwork for me to go away that I enlisted. You know, I signed that paper, and 2 days later, I was on a bus on my way to Parris Island. I didn't make them wait 5 years for me to serve them.
The VA denied our request for an on-camera interview, but in this letter, it states Geiger's request for benefits was rejected in part because VA doctors found he suffered from protein C deficiency, which it calls a genetic disorder. And it is less likely than not that the protein C deficiency is related to contaminated water. But in two letters to the VA, Geiger's oncologist claims exposure to toxic water cannot be ruled out.
They're waiting for us to either get fed up with it and just go away, or they're waiting for us to gradually die off so they don't have to pay the claims.
But with each trip to Washington, Ensminger pushes hard for legislation.
To force the Marine Corps to hold up their moral obligation.
His drive comes from his own loss. His daughter, Janie, was born at Camp Lejeune in 1976. When she was 6 years old, doctors diagnosed her with leukemia. 2.5 years later, Janie died.
Your first response is shock. And after the shock wears off, you do what any normal human being does, and you begin to wonder why.
A media report suggested the possible cause. Ensminger investigated and found many others who wanted answers from the Marine Corps.
I swore that I'm not going to let these people get away with this.
The Agency for Toxic Substances and Disease Registry, ATSDR, has been conducting a health study of children exposed to the water while in the womb. The study won't be complete until next year. Until then, the Marine Corps says notifying personnel who were at the base before 1985 would be premature. Ensminger isn't giving up.
When you pat me in the face with a shovel and blow taps over me, I said, that's when I'll stop this fight. Or whenever you do what's right.
Nick Geiger also isn't giving up, but the VA says he'll have to provide new evidence before it will reconsider his claim for health benefits. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm Barry Sims.